my eggs are safe in a freezer in Minnesota, where there are never earthquakes or hurricanes or anything scarier than a blizzard, which might actually be beneficial. With that out of the way, it was time for me to prepare for chemo. Luckily, my friend Nina had been down this road and was able to offer advice.
So, your chemo infusion is going to last a couple of hours and you're going to get hungry. So my favorite are these trail mix packs, salty and sweet.
Ah, my favorite!
Me too! And you need to stay hydrated. This is very important because it helps your body flush out the drugs faster.
And that's good?
Yes. Oh, and you'll need something to do. Let's see. Puzzle books.
Sudoku.
Oh, and Stars of the 90s. A magazine like this is best because it never goes out of date. The Kardashians drama changes weekly, but the Stars of the 90s are forever.
So true. Plastic forks?
Your food will taste terrible. Metallic. Using plastic cutlery helps. And don't be afraid of using spices. Salt and pepper are your friends.
Always have been.
You may get mouth sores. I minimize this by sucking on cold popsicles during my infusion. The coldness of the popsicles actually slows down the cells and protects them from being targeted by the chemo.
Crazy!
It seems to work. I'm also going to give you this Biotene mouthwash toothpaste for dry mouth.
Another symptom?
Chemo will dry out everything, including your skin, lips, and eyes, which is why I'm going to give you this lotion, okay, lip balm, and eye drops.
Great! Any other fun side effects?
Some people experience extreme nausea. I didn't, but I did have ginger tea and candied ginger to fend off the nausea.
Okay.
There's also hair loss. Satin pillowcases reduce the friction at night and lessen the amount of hair you'll find on your pillow in the morning, which is always freaky.
Okay.
Eventually, you'll lose all your hair everywhere, including your eyelashes. So I use these ones to make myself look more like myself.
Nice.
And being bald is always colder than you think. So I wear this nightcap at night to keep my head warm. Oh, and speaking of being cold, warm socks. Chemo wards are always freezing.
Great. Anything else?
Well, that's it. So, you feel ready?
Totally. Kinda. I don't know. I mean, you know, logistically, I feel prepared, but...
But emotionally unprepared.
Exactly. I mean, this is just the beginning of a shitty journey where ultimately I am going to lose a lot.
Yes, but you'll gain your health.
Which I don't really feel like I've lost, you know? I mean, people keep sending me these get well soon cards and I'm thinking, well, I'm already well.
Breast cancer is shitty that way. It's the treatment more than the cancer that makes you feel like you're dying.
Yeah. I am not ready.
I think you should call Laura.
Why?
I didn't do this, but I know a lot of women who did things to, like, commemorate the journey and empower themselves before their treatments. Things like, you know, photographing themselves and their breasts.
You think I should call Laura and have her photograph my tits?
Yeah, I mean, why not? She's a friend. She's a great photographer. I mean, it's not my thing, but I think pictures of your boobs might make you feel better.
What does that say about me?
Oh my god, Laura, it's so great to see you.
Oh, you too. I am so excited. This whole idea is just awesome sauce. I'm so happy I can help you do this.
I am so grateful you are willing to help me do this.
Oh, hashtag totally psyched. So, do you have any ideas of what you want to do?
No. I have no ideas.
Oh, no problem. I was looking stuff up online. Okay, and there's a lot of different ideas. But firstly, I'm thinking we should be doing this outside.
Outside?
Yes. Maybe Brooklyn Bridge Park. But, you know, we want to avoid crowds. So we're going to have to get there really early, like 6 or 7 in the morning. Because the light will still be good and the streets will be empty.
The morning of the shoot, we got to Brooklyn Bridge Park at 6 a.m. The light was good, the streets were empty-ish, and it was a balmy 32 degrees. And it was raining.
Look at you, hashtag so cute.
Thanks.
Okay, so it is a little cold, but we're gonna make it work. We're gonna do our first look here, okay, get as much as we can before the people start coming through with the babies and the joggers, dogs, and all that stuff.
Hashtag awkward.
Totally, take off your top. Okay, great, great, this is nice. Could you tilt to your left? Yeah, your nipple shadowed. Hashtag perky, but shadowed. Here's a jogger. Oh, it's a lady jogger, so she's probably seen boobs before.
The human jogger, so she's probably seen boobs before.
Hashtag so true. Go on ahead, don't mind us. I've never seen this girl before in my life. This is perfect. Whip them out, but be a little careful.
Why?
I'm pretty sure that's a police station.
It's totally legal to bare your breasts in public in New York.
Yeah, but is it legal to take pictures of them in public, or is it porn? Yeah, whip them out. Okay, great, great. Can you lean back a little? No, like arch your back. Perfect.
Boy, Blondie, looking good. We need more of that in Brooklyn.
Hashtag New York's finest.
Yeah, you can say that again.
Don't be gross, dude.
What? I was talking about her hair.
Actually, your hair does look amazing.
Hey, how was the photo shoot?
Good! Surprisingly empowering running around the city without my top on.
Wait, what happened?
Nothing. She got some great shots.
Are you okay?
I don't want to lose my hair. I love my hair. I don't want to be bald.
Everything you're feeling is entirely valid.
It's gonna suck if I lose my hair and I have to spend years growing it back and I will look terrible.
I'm really proud of you for doing what you need to do to take care of yourself. I will always think you're beautiful, regardless of your hair.
But no cops will whistle at me.
Seriously, what happened today?